My focus is on 11:11. Let's look at verse 1 for a moment. Verse 1 says, come, everyone who is thirsty, come to the waters, and you without money, come buy meat. Come buy wine and milk without money and without cost. Why do you spend money on what is not food, and your wages on what does not satisfy? Listen carefully to me and eat what is good, and you will enjoy the choices of foods. Verse 11. So my word that comes from my mouth will not return to me empty, but it will accomplish what I please and will prosper in what I send it to do. Now, y'all already got the verse. How many of y'all are here tonight that believe that something has been taken from you that should have been taken? Yeah, you know how we lose stuff? We don't believe we should lose. Y'all ever been in that situation?
Yeah.
Somebody took something from you or you done lost something. I've never had a house broken in, but somebody broke in my truck one time and stole some stuff. And I felt like I was sitting there when they came. You know how you get mad after the fact. It's kind of like you go down the street after somebody that made you mad and you smile at them before it. You get down the street, that sun is bothering you. But you get down the street, and then after you get down the street, you get real mad after you left the person. Y'all been in those situations? Y'all been in that situation? Oh, somebody made me mad. I get down the street. Sam and I think about it too long. I'm going to turn around and go back and do something that I shouldn't do. But I was looking at this, and in Isaiah prophesied for the children of God. It was a prophetic word Isaiah actually was given to the people of God. Now, for the last few weeks, I've been basically dealing with commitment. I've been dealing with how people ought to commit to the church, how to commit to God, how to commit to ministry. I've been dealing with commitment. Sunday I talked about how that we as a maker, we ought to come to a point that we ought to be able to do what we need to do. We ought to manage, maker. That's basically what we ought to do. We ought to, if God had given us a gifting, if God had done something with us, we ought to be able to do it. We shouldn't look for people to hold our hand, basically to get to that place. That's basically what I talked about Sunday, and I'm adding to what I said on Sunday. But I was looking at this tonight, and Isaiah talked about something that we always look for. Bless you. We always look for God to do something for us. That's our prayer. Our prayer is that God will bless our lives. God will do different things in our lives. Because one thing we say we deserve. Remember, that's what we always say. We deserve it. Deserve. But the Bible says, he said, come now and let us reason together, said the Lord. Right? He said, though your sin be as scarlet, it be white as snow. But now he's telling me, he said, come and get the water and you don't have to pay for it. But what actually happened was, I got situated in the come now and let us reason together. Because what I did, I lined myself up to what God had for me. I actually put myself in position to gain what God had for me. And so when we get to dealing with somebody taking something from me, the devil has taken a lot of stuff from us. The devil has taken a lot of, if you can look back over your life and look back over the things that have really happened in your life, some things you just didn't give up, some things you didn't put yourself in a position to lose. You just basically lost it. You lost those things and you feel bad a lot of times because you lost in some situations and some areas that you don't believe personally that you should have lost it. And so we start praying. We start praying. We ask God all these old questions that we ask God. We lay before the Lord. And now the only time we lay before God is when we get sick. do what I need to do. I start laying before God and I start questioning, why is this, God? Why is this happening to me? Why am I losing in this area? You go back when Job started losing. Job lost a lot of stuff. And the Bible said Job was a devout man. He was a man that loved God. He loved what God was doing. He loved ministry with God. But in one day, in one sitting, Job lost his family. He lost his cattle. He lost his business. He lost money. He lost friends. I mean, this is one sitting. In 24 hours, Job got up one morning and boom, all hell broke loose. And a lot of times in our lives, stuff starts happening when it's just going every now and then. I lose this, or I might lose some money. I went to the ATM and didn't get all my money out, or the ATM took my money and the bank did not honor that I got. That's fine. I can lose $60. I gave somebody $100. I can lose $100. But when it comes down to that thick stuff, that I feel like that I shouldn't have lost it. And you go to thinking, I was in the hospital, I told God, I said, God, if you let me out of the hospital, this is what I'm going to do. But then I got sicker. In my praying, I got sicker. Maybe I had a loved one, and I was praying. And I said, God, if you'll just save them, if you'll heal them, and then they died. Do it change the effect of God? No, it don't. And so when Isaiah got to talking, Isaiah said that the reason we're losing is because we don't know how to shout. Isaiah said, the enemy has taken us and attacked us. We don't know how to shout and shoot.
All right.
See, once you got a shout down, this is why I feel an anointing now. I can run. Listen, once you got an anointing down inside of you, there's a shout that the enemy will never deceive you where you are.
All right.
I understand what he's saying. Now, let me show you. It said, come everyone who is thirsty.
Yeah.
Now, what he really asked was, how thirsty are you? Because in Matthew, when Jesus showed up, and the anointing of God showed up, when the Spirit of God went and started administering itself in the land, what he said was, he said, if you're thirsty, he said, I'll give you drink. Know the Bible said, right?
Yeah.
Isaiah prophesied it before it actually happened. Because what he said was, he said, if you're thirsty and you're able to come, he said, you'll get drink. Now, see, we put stipulation on everything we do. We say, I can't do that. I ain't going down there and embarrass myself. Don't know what we said, though. I ain't got the right clothes on. I ain't looking just right. Isaiah said, if you don't have no money, don't stop coming.
That's right.
Oh, boy. What sense do that mean? We get to this place where we don't know how to shout out what God put in us. If he really put something down inside of me, the enemy cannot control what's in me.
Amen.
I get so upset. I want to cuss. I want all this hollering. I'm hollering for nonsense. I'm not hollering to the right thought. Yeah, but if I'm hollering for the right reason, because that spirit that's inside of me, because what it's actually doing is bringing out what God has planted in me. And so when I come to a thirsty facet in life, what God is doing is releasing what the devil can't touch.
All right.
See, we mess ourselves up because we don't know how to come to a fountain and drink what has already been paid for us. It's already been paid for. So when people start taking your money, when people start taking things from you, that stuff that they take, it can belong to you at that point. But this is what God said. He said, when you start shouting, I'm going to release it out of the devil's hand and give it back to you.
All right now.
Woo, Lord.
Oh, Lord.
We go to crying about what I've lost and what I don't have. And I was reading this. God said, the rain comes and it falls on the ground. And then the Bible said that the rain returns back to God. But before it returns, it waters and replenishes the ground. God said, whatever I've given unto you, he said, when it falls, I'm going to let it replenish in you. How many of you need a replenishing? Yeah, how many of us got to a sad point to where we're so drained that it seemed like our prayer life sign up for this? I didn't sign up for all this rhetoric in my life. I didn't sign up for stuff that, you know, God give me to. Why are you going to take something? You know, people used to say, we go over your place and put your hands on it, name it, and claim it, you know, that kind of stuff. But then I lose it. I got a 5,000 square foot house, and then for 2 or 3 years, I pay for the house, and then one year, it seemed like I just can't pay for it. I can't pay for that nice car to drive around. Everybody been giving me accolades, and you know, I've been parlayed and all that kind of stuff around. And now I'm about to. Now I got to look like a. Do you actually believe that God will give us something and take it away if it belongs to me? Said a thief has come in the night, and in a moment he has taken from you. But I am coming to put a shout in a shot within you. The shout will come up and out of your mouth like a shot. This shout will apprehend the enemy and cause the thief to let go what he has stolen.
All right.
Now,
touchdown. So when he said it, he talked about the return. He says, seek the Lord while he may be found. Call to him while he is near. And so the activity of it is that I'm going to seek God while he's available to me. Because if I get so wrapped up and tied up when he's not, because see, sometimes I get it myself. I get selfish. I get stubborn, and I don't need God today. And then those days that I really need God, he's not here. And I think in Isaiah 56 or 59, he said, my arms is not too short that I can reach you, neither my ears too heavy that I can hear you. He said, but you have moved from me. And so what God is saying is, he said, since you have moved, he said, I'm still standing. He said, but you have to seek me while I can be there for you. Now, how many of y'all get up during the day and move around all day? Most of us do, because we start moving at night and we call you night crawler. And sometimes, a certain time of night, you go to movement. That ain't good. But I was noticing something today. I was riding all day. But I noticed that it's a lot of activity going on today. Traffic on 55, on Lakeland Drive, you know, on Sidewell Road, on 18. That's traffic anyway. Where all these folks come from? But then I've been out at night. Been out at 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 10 o'clock. And after about 6 or 7 o'clock, the traffic slows down. Why do y'all think it slows down after a certain time? Everybody goes home resting, right?
Yes, right.
That's what they should be doing. They should be resting. That's what they should be doing. We've come to a day that all of us are not resting. But I found out that God moves in a busy time. He moves in a busy time. I'm not saying he don't move in a quiet time, because he does. That's his most strongest time, in the quiet time. But in the daytime, there's so much activity going on. That's when you really need God.
Amen.
When the activity of the day is going on, that's when you really need God. Because there's so much stuff at you. The devil want to distract you where you are, and so he picks the day. He starts throwing stuff at you, and we think, Sam, this is what we believe. This is just a job. You know, people just in the supermarket. It's just people. And so we downplay it. It's just that activity that's going on. The devil attack you sometimes, most of the time, when there's a lot of people around you.
All right.
Because what he does, when the enemy come at you, he's going to come at you one way, but you got all these other distractions at you, and you're really not going to see the powerfulness of that demon at you.
Okay.
Yeah, did that make sense?
Yes, sir.
You got all these demons coming at you, but you got one particular demon want to keep. You think that this is just how it's supposed to be? No. God said that you need to seek me where I can be found. When you get up in the morning, your objective is, before you start your ramble, you need to go ahead and tell God thank you. The first thing you ought to do is tell God thank you. And then you ought to tell him to guide you throughout the day. Because there are some days, Jessica, there are some days that I be wanting to go somewhere and the Lord said, don't go right now. I wonder why I can't go now. Don't go right now. Find out on the news somebody got killed at that spot.
I used to tell folk, that if I got all the money back that I've let people have, or people have taken from me, or let them pay me, I would have to work another day in my life. I would have to work another day. Talk about getting up. Y'all want to cut that noise out of me now?
All right.
We don't have to do anything.
Yes.
If I could get back. And so when I was reading this, God told me he was going to get it back. Oh, God. Now, I know a lot of people have quick dream scheme thing. So we go get the lottery tickets and all that stuff. We go to plan. I'm going to tell you what a lot of people do. They try to manipulate God and get those tickets. They get the ticket. And they praying. And then somebody said, what you going to do with that money if you get it? The first thing I'm going to do is give my tithes to the church. The government has got bad. wife wasn't going to let you do that.
What you mean, let me do anything?
Okay.
I got a bad problem with that. That's part of your shot.
Yes, sir.
Because what they used to didn't let do, you don't have to let them do nothing.
That's right.
I got a bad problem with that, y'all.
Okay.
I got a serious problem with that. Now, see, what God has given me, He given me authority, and we have to walk in authority.
That's right.
Amen.
You can't shout until you walk in authority.
Amen.
You have to get in a position to where you say, okay, God, I got what I got, and I'm going to do what I need to do. God said, you got to come and let us get to this place where you're drinking free water. He said, because I've given you opportunity, I've given you a way out of things. And then He come here, and He said, you have to seek your way while you found, call to Him while He's near. And then in the 11th verse, I didn't ever get to the 11th verse, did I?
Yes, sir.
Did I? Yes, sir. All right. Well, let me go back to the 11th verse. Can I see any glasses? Okay, there you go. It says, so my word that comes from my mouth would not return to me empty. And so if God said it, if He said it, if it come out of God's mouth, that's what he said. He said, but it will accomplish what I please and will prosper in what I send it to do. And so whatever God put His name on, now how many of us call ourselves children of God? And the Bible said that He would never start in a man that He can't complete. Amen. And so if God started something in us, He's able, and I don't care how much you want to stop, you can't stop on the plan of God because He's already established something in you.
Amen.
That, I don't care how long we sit down. The thing of it is that when we sit down, there's something inside of us keep us moving. Jeremiah said, how will a man have hot coals put upon his chest and he shall not be moved? Amen. You're going to have it. If something's hot on you, so if something down inside of me, it's going to cause a shout out of me. And when that shout comes out of me, it releases the blessing that God has for me that the devil has stolen from me.
Yes, sir.
And so when I get home, I don't give up when I get to the house. Well, you said, well, Pastor, the lights on, light a candle.
All right, man.
Amen. Don't nobody have to know your lights off. Let me tell y'all this. If you pray long enough, they won't be all gone.
Amen.
God will send somebody back.
Amen.
Your light. What's wrong with your light? I couldn't pay the bill. How much is it? He said, come and drink. You ain't got no money.
Okay.
That ain't all we're talking about a fountain, is it?
Right.
No. Because sometimes I don't have light money. Sometimes I don't have gas money. He'll do it for me, and I'll do it for him. But he was at the gas station up here, and he was going through a bad time. And he said, man, I'm gonna put me about $10 gas in the car. I said, where are you? He said, I'm up at the gas station. I said, okay. I just kept calling on the phone. And I got up there. I said, what you gonna put in? He said, about $10. I said, let's go and fill it up.
That's
right. Okay. Somebody said, well, why are you? You don't know where you are. I don't care where you go.
All right.
I just need God to have no gas station.
All right.
Because see, if it ran out of gasoline, he gonna call me again. I'm gonna fill up. I didn't want to have to go pick him up. And there's a lot of times when you're in the will of God, what God does, God allows people to meet you where you are. But because we're so stagnated and we're so hindered by wrong, we got stuff in our mind. They're going to talk about me. Who cares?
Yeah.
I don't care about anybody. You know when you're a fool and people talk about you, you feel better. But if you hunger, they talk about you. You got double jeopardy on your hands. Yeah. Amen. I don't care about you. He needed what? Something to eat. Did you buy? Yeah. And you're talking about talk back. See, we're so embarrassed by stuff that God already promised us. I told y'all. See, there's a lot of guys. That truck I got out there. Somebody else could buy the truck. I bought the truck. Now one day the Lord gonna release that truck from me. He said, what? Yeah, he gonna release that truck. The person that could not buy it, he gonna put it in my way.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe they'll buy it from me, but they won't buy it for the price I bought it for. Mm-hmm. Uh-oh. See, I'm coming to I'm telling y'all, this is how God works. See, there's a lot of times when this building, I told y'all this before, when this building was being built, I knew this was a mega building. God showed it to me. I couldn't get the building when they first did, because they had to clear the land and all that money. I probably had a lot of money put in this building. This used to be some trees and stuff like that. But when they started building the building, got it up. I said, "My building. The Lord said, that's your building. Are we in the building?" Don't worry about it. He's on his way back. But you You got to get a shout down inside. You got to put a shout, and I'm talking about every chance you get. You let that shout come out.
All right.
The enemy releases it. It's coming out. Y'all see that commercial? Y'all see that commercial where the little girl, she was shorter than everybody else. She stood about so high. And she was on the basketball team. And they had the sticky notes. And she about this high. And they said, you go first. They thought she wasn't going to be able to jump. And she ran up there and jumped up and put that shit tomorrow.
Right.
I'm going to do a little higher.
Right.
That's what God is telling y'all.
Yeah.
You might look like it. You can't make it. But to prepare for it.
Right.
And tomorrow, I'm going to jump a little higher. That's all he's saying. Tomorrow, I'm going to get a little higher. Tomorrow, I'm going to get a little heavier in my shot.
Okay.
And so in my shot, the devil going to have to release every day something back to me. Now, I'm going to tell y'all this. The Bible says in Mark 11:22, it says, you said in this mountain, be thou moved, cast in the sea, and believe it in your heart, it shall happen. Now, you're going to have to believe what I'm saying. You can't go home and say, well, that was just a good Bible generation.
Yeah.
This is not just a good Bible.
That's right.
I wouldn't have wasted my time. I wouldn't have wasted 45 minutes telling you about Bible for the lesson.
That's right.
I'm trying to govern your life where you can see that there's another. It's better. That was a song. That was a song. I don't know the song. I might even mess it up. I'm not going to try to sing it. I promise. But that was a song. They said, greater is coming. I think that was a song. What is it? Greater is coming. That's not a song. Y'all heard that song?
Yeah.
Y'all like that song? We got a good melody. Listen. If y'all can get that in y'all's spirit.
That's right.
If you get in your spirit and believe it. I'm talking about believe it. See, you shouldn't live up under the box. Sam, this thing is so great right now. I ask God this. I said, God, when is it going to be where I can encourage people to do it your way? He said, you've been doing it all the time.
Okay.
This is a girl coming to my shop. She's been coming to my shop now for the last 4 weeks. But she come this morning. And she, not only yesterday, she came yesterday. She had some amazing look on her face. She just looked crazy. Her mama looked crazy. And I sat there in the shop and I said, God, that's crazy. That's crazy. So this morning, I got a nerve up. Shonda, I asked her this morning. I said, what church do you go to? She told me what church you go to. And she said, why are you having that? I said, well, you come over here. You've been coming over here. I said, you got the craziest look on your woman. I said, that's depressed all the time.
Okay.
I said, I'm going to tell you, need to change churches.
Okay.
I said, maybe you're not getting them where you at. I said, well, and she said, well, he teaches about tithing. I said, baby, I'm going to invite you to Bible class. I don't want you as a member. I said, I ain't trying to solicit your member. I said, but if you're going to Bible class tonight, I said, I try to teach a practical understanding about the Word of God to where it'll govern your life the next day. That's not what I try to do. I try to govern your life to where you can be excited about the next day. And she said, well, I'm like, I knew she wouldn't come. Oh my God. Let me tell y'all something. Whenever we get this depression in us, and we don't believe that God is God, we'll let the enemy steal every part of happiness we have out of us. We get up sad. We walk around and say, every day is rough. It's just bad. I mean, we drain life out of everybody else because it's bad. People hate you come around. They look at you. Oh, God, that you come again. It's just bad. Get some excitement in you. Because if God has given you a shout, and you talk about greater is he that's in me, that he that's in the world, no weapon for. You need to tell me I'm walking around like the enemy to beat me up. The devil is alive.
Yeah.
said, if I let the rain fall and it comes back to me, that I can replenish the earth, I can replenish your life. How many of you are ready to be replenished? How many of you are tired of being where you are? Well, it only takes one step. And I ain't talking about moving your foot. It takes one step in your mind that I want to be different.
All right, all right.
Because he did make me different.
Yeah.
He made me different.
He made me different.
Yeah, I don't do it like everybody else. He made me different.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm unusual. Yeah. Chosen generation, a peculiar people.
Yeah, that's it.
He made me different.
Yeah.
When I get it in my mind that I can do it a different way, he instills a shout inside of me.
Yeah.
So I need y'all to start shouting and shooting what you shout. Make it count.
Amen.
I used to tell folk all the time, if I pull my pistol out, I'm going to shoot somebody. I ain't shooting over there, but it costs too much. I don't give warning shots. I'm gonna shoot somebody, that's all it is. Amen. I'm shooting at something. So I need y'all to start shooting at something. God's gonna make your life better.
Yes.
I pray that this lesson tonight and encourage you. Encourage you. Let's start shouting. Let's start shouting. I promise you. God is already, it's down, it's ready to come out. All you gotta do is unlock the box. It's ready to come out. Amen. Remember about that time I told y'all that I got up to sing and wouldn't nothing come out? And then when my daddy said, "You gonna sing?" "Yeah, I'm gonna sing that song." And I got up, they got the plan. They were playing, you know, they played for a while, and then they get to that point where you're supposed to start singing, and they were playing, they got that point.
God said we need to.
Bible says that we shouldn't despise all the enemy.
That's right.
So I told you on Sunday that for 9 years we played around. Now it's time to get busy.
That's right.
It's time to structure where we are. And so that's what we're doing. God has allowed administration to come through here.
Amen.
And we're going to administer. We're going to structure the work that God has for us. It's going to take a little time. But
amen.
I promise you, if you're hanging there with me,
amen.
We're going to make it happen.
Amen.
But I need some willing people.
Amen.
If I come to you, if the team come to you and ask you about something, please just say okay.
Amen.
We've prayed about it. You know, if you got in our spirit, that's the person that God gave us. And I just need, even if you don't stay here for long, help us get it started.
Amen.
Help us get it started. If you see something that needs changing, get with the person that's in charge of it and help them change it.
Amen.
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 We can make it work.
Amen.
But I've been praying, see. God will direct the church in the way it should go. Let's pray.
Amen.
We thank you, God, now for tonight.
Thank
you for the word that you've sent forth tonight.
Thank you.
We pray, God, now that you will continue to establish what that it is aimed for. And we continue to pray and believe in you, God. We believe in your work. We believe in the power that you've allowed in our lives. And we thank you, God, you've chosen us for such a time as this, oh God. And we realize that we are worthy of the work that's before us, oh God. We're worthy of what you've called us to do, God. And we're called, oh God, because each individual in this place, oh God, is for here for a particular reason. And so, God, because we're here for that reason, God, we ask that you establish in us a mindset of obedience, oh God. We need obedience in order to follow you in every aspect. And so, God, I thank you again. Dreams on top of dreams, vision on top of vision, oh God. Lay it out, oh God, that Master will continue to understand that you're talking to us, that you're speaking to us, oh God, in such a way, oh God, that the kingdom will be developed in us. And so, God, I thank you again for tonight. I thank you for the person that have obligated themselves, oh God, just to come forth and say, for God I live, for God I'm willing to die. And so, God, I bless you now. I bless you for the shout that's inside of us, oh God. That, Master, the shout that will turn into a shout, God. That, Master, we can be able to defeat the enemy just where he is, God. And he returned back to us that he stole it. And so, God, I bless you tonight. And I'm asking, Master, that you prepare us and put us in position to receive those things that will return to us, God. That, Master, we would not be so excited and overwhelmed, oh God, believing that we don't believe that you sent it to us. But, Master, because your word has went forth, we're looking, we're expecting, oh God, a blessing on top of blessing. We ask, oh God, now that the names that were called out tonight, God, Jonathan and Wellers and Mr. Kelly and Mr. Cooper, oh God, we pray, Master, now that you will bless their lives, and whatever the need is, oh God, we ask, oh God, that you will heal even right now, knowing that you are able and you're willing, oh God, you're standing there for us, oh God. All you said we need to do is be obedient and ask for you, God. And Master, you said the faithful, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. And so, God, we thank you again tonight. We thank you, God, for their names, oh God. We thank you for the intercession, oh God. We thank you, God, for those that were standing together on their behalf, oh God. We thank you, Master, that they will believe even in themselves, oh God, that there's a greater work, there's a greater power, there's a greater healer, oh God, other than the doctor, oh God. We pray, oh God, now, whatever situation that they're in, oh God, we ask, oh God, to release now, oh God, that Master, they'll continue to understand you. Thank you, oh God, for every home that's in this place tonight, oh God, every family, oh God, that's in this place tonight, God, every mindset that's in this place tonight, oh God. We ask, oh God, that we'll be continually encouraged, oh God, to know that you are there with us and for us, oh God, in the darkest times, in the hard times, in the troubled times, oh God, in the impatient times, oh God. Let them know right now, God, that you are right there. Faith moves mountains, oh God. And we pray, God, now that as faith comes forth, oh God, your work will come forth. Your word will continue to be implemented in our lives, oh God. Thank you, Master, right now for the breakthrough that's coming in this place, oh God. Chains are being broken off young minds and young spirits, oh God. They're going to be instructed and structured, oh God, in the way that you told us we must go, oh God. There's a destruction on the land, oh God. But, Master, you told us you're going to construct, oh God, in us, oh God, for the kingdom. And so, God, I thank you, Master, right now for every movement, oh God, that you will make in this place. Thank you, God, for your word. Thank you, God, for your power. Thank you for your anointing, oh God. Thank you, God, for strengthening us, oh God. Thank you now, Master, that you allowed us to be conduit, oh God, for our nation, oh God.
God, now that you've trusted me enough.
Yes.
And Master, I'll be able to give a solid word to these young people. Thank you, Master, that they will believe what you said for tonight. And we ask, oh God, to continue to keep us now.
Yes.
Continue to keep us as we travel back to our destination. It's in Jesus' name that we pray tonight. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.